हेलो ब्यूटीफुल पेरेंट्स, वेलकम टू मॉम ऑन बोर्ड। अवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज अगेन सजेस्टेड बाय वन ऑफ अवर सब्सक्राइबर। थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर ब्यूटीफुल सजेशन। एक्चुअली शी इज वेरी गुड फ्रेंड ऑफ माइंड। थैंक यू सो मच। अवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज पोस्ट डिलीवरी वेट लॉस। एवरी वुमन जस्ट वॉन्ट दिस टॉपिक। आई थिंक दिस इज अ ड्रीम टॉपिक फॉर एवरी वुमन। दिस इज हैपन विथ मी ऑल्सो। आई जस्ट सो डेस्पिरेट फॉर सर्चिंग दिस टॉपिक वेन आई डिलीवर अ बेबी बॉय। आफ्टर दैट आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू बिकम इन माई ओरिजिनल शेप। Yes, every woman just want that. Being a mother, being enjoying a motherhood journey is very good phase. I think it's a world best phase for every woman. And enjoying with this phase, every woman just want to retain her original shape. Why not? Every woman should want that and must want that, because it's obviously give us a positivity, a motivation, a enthusiasm. When we return to our original shape, it just give us the confidence that we are looking good, and so much of compliments we are gaining, and every woman wants that compliment. I also enjoyed or experienced this kind of journey. So weight loss after delivery, it's very crucial for every woman, or every woman must desire that she should retain her original shape, or she must be fitting in her original clothes. So it's a very good feeling when we retain our shape. So without wasting much more time, here we are starting our today's video, that is a post delivery weight loss. Before starting important topics or important tips of the weight loss, I just want to give a little bit of information regarding the post delivery weight loss. When exactly it started? Yes, when we talk about the post delivery weight loss, that means it does start from the post delivery? No, it actually starts when you are pregnant. Because in pregnancy we are gaining as much as I think 15 to 20 kg of weight, and if you are planning and if you are limiting your weight at that phase, then post delivery weight loss journey is very easy for you. So in pregnancy, what you have to do, first of all, please don't eat too much junk food. I know pregnancy is a very beautiful journey or a beautiful phase. You are having so much kind of different cravings, like some have for sugar cravings, some have salt cravings, some have sour cravings. Obviously you should enjoy that, and you must enjoy that phase, but keeping in mind that eating too much junk food, eating too much sugary, it's not going to help to retain your face, retain your shape after delivery, and ultimately it's just increasing your unnecessary weight. Because of that eating junk food or any extra sugar, your baby is not gaining weight, your baby's growth will not be healthy. It's just a craving. So if you really want to eat that, you can eat, but at least minimize the frequency, at least cut down the frequency. That will ultimately help you to retain your shape after delivery. So this is the first thing you have to do. Then second thing is keep busy or keep active while you are pregnant. In different kind of activity, keep yourself busy. Pregnancy is just not a phase that you are just relaxing, you are sitting at one place and you are eating something, that is you are having craving for that. No, it is not going to happen. You have to busy, you have to engage yourselves, like in different things, like walking or doing light dancing or doing yoga. Regarding walking, there is no such kind of any guidance required. Walking is just walking, you can do that. But when I am talking about the yoga or the light dancing, then in that case a proper practice must be there, a proper guidance must be there. So you have to go to physiotherapist or you have to go to yoga expert, that will help you or benefit you in various ways, that will teaches you a very good method of practicing that. So this is the second point. You have to keep busy yourself in doing any kind of activity that feels you very good from the inside. Then the last important tip is, when you are pregnant, you obviously increase 15 to 20 kgs of weight, but as soon as you deliver a baby, then 7 to 8 kgs, in most of the cases up to 9 kgs weight is automatically reduced, because you deliver a baby and with that the all blood and all water is coming out. So ultimately at that point you are 6 to 7 kg, we can consider 7 kgs of weight will be reduced. So you can relax at that point. But what happened when our 6 to 7 kgs of weight is reduced? when we deliver a baby, then we have to cut down or maintain our weight at that point, because unfortunately this is not happened with me. After losing 7 kg of weight immediate delivery, I just put on the double weight, because at that time I just went to at my hometown and just I ate so much of ghee and so much of rotis that ultimately increases my weight. And I remember I increased up to 75 kgs. So this is my mistake, which is I had made by myself. You should not do that. When your weight is decreased after delivery by 6 to 7 kg, please maintain that ratio. I know in after pregnancy you have to eat extra, but the amount is only 300 to 400 of calorie is sufficient for milk making, for breast milk feeding mother. Unnecessarily do not eat too much in the thinking of that the amount you are eating that ultimately get converted into all breast milk. No, this is not exactly happens. That the remaining food which is not converted into breast milk, that is converted into the fat, and that increases your body weight, which is exactly happened with me. So you make sure you are cutting or you are limiting your weight at that point when you are reduce your 6 to 7 kgs of weight immediate after delivery. This is the most important tip. Now we are moving towards the weight loss tips. What are the different weight loss tips? First important is breastfeeding. Yes, breastfeeding is very important. As much as you breastfeed your baby, that calories or that fat is get converted into the breast milk, that all calories is just get busy in forming the milk, and ultimately your weight will be reduced because that calories and fats are going from your body, and that is having a positive effect on your baby because your baby is gaining the healthy weight. So it's a kind of a passage. Your body is giving that calorie or fat to your baby, your weight is reducing and your baby's weight is increasing. So this is a very good transformation. So try to breastfeed your baby as much as you can. Try to avoid formula milk or any other milk, because breast milk is having a so much of all vitamins, nutrients, which is essential for your baby, and ultimately that will help in losing weight of yours. So it's benefit you, your baby. So breastfeeding is a very best way in losing weight after post delivery. Then second point is drink water. Drinking water is very important. If a normal woman want to lose weight, then in that case drinking water is very beneficial for her. And for a post delivery woman, drinking water is also a very good thing. In a day minimum, keep in mind that you have to drink 8 to 10 glasses of water, because water is gives a very much benefits to your body. In my case, I remember my pediatrician told me that for a good breast milk forming or fast breast milk formation, if you are drinking a lukewarm water, that will obviously give a very positive effect. If you are trying it on yourself, then definitely that will also increases the ratio of weight reduction for you. So if you are preferring lukewarm water for a whole day, you can try it. Or otherwise, if you are drinking a normal water, that will also give a benefit to you. But one tip is very important. When your day start, try to drink 2 glasses of lukewarm water. If you want to squeeze out lemon in it, or if you want to add the honey in it, that is always give a benefit to you. It's up to you. If you are not recommending that, or if you just want to drink 2 glasses of lukewarm water at the day start, then obviously that will give benefit to you. But if you are maintaining that lukewarm water drinking for the whole day, then the ratio of weight reduction will be increased. This is very positive for you in reduction the weight. So this is most important, you can follow that. Then the effect of water is very important. It helps in our digestion, and ultimately our digestion is smooth, then our stomach is smooth, and ultimately that will help in reducing the weight. So water intake in a day for at least 8 to 10 glasses must be included for your weight reduction journey. Then the last tip regarding drinking water is very much important. Actually, I had followed on myself, and currently I am having that practice. It just give you a wonderful result. before taking any food, means your breakfast, your lunch or dinner, just 15 to 20 minutes before that, drink one glass of water. That will give a kind of room in stomach, and that will prohibit you from eating unnecessary food or eating extra food that is actually not required by your body. So this is a very good tip, you can follow that. And plus on, it obviously helps in reducing the weight. So drinking one glass of water before taking any food, before taking any meal, that will obviously help you in reducing the your post delivery weight. Then the next important tip is get fit with your baby. In this tip, what you have to do exactly, the new mother generally they are hesitate or they are having some kind of laziness, so they are not following this tip. But if you are following that, then ultimately that will really help you in losing your post delivery weight. What exactly you have to do, you have to keep yourself engaged or busy with your baby for initial 40 days. I know it's your recovery period, you can't go outside, it's totally okay, but for the 40 days you can keep engaged or keep busy yourself with your baby's activity. Just try to fold their clothes or just do household activities that are not so much heavy for you, that are just light. You can do that activity by sitting, so ultimately that helps you in keeping active, and ultimately that will for long term benefit you in reducing your weight. Then the second thing you can do after 40 days, walk with your baby. Just keep your baby in a pram and just go on the walk. You can go in the morning session or you can go in the evening session. For both the session, if you are comfortable, then you can go. Don't keep in mind that I have to lose weight, so I just have to walk fastly. No, that is not essential, that is not necessary. It's totally depend on your health. When you are having that much strength, when you are having that much capability, then slowly increase your walk speed. For sure, half an hour in the morning, half an hour in the evening, you can walk with your baby. After 40 days, when you are taking your baby outside, your baby is also feeling that nature kind of thing. Your baby also going close to that nature. When I'm talking about walking, that means you are not going to the mall or shopping or anything. Just go in the garden or in your society's a park where the play area is. In that, baby is seeing the other babies. Baby is getting near about the nature. So ultimately your baby is just born in the nature, so it's perfectly right or perfectly comfortable for him. And ultimately when you are taking your baby outside after 40 days, slowly his or her immune system is also developed, because that baby gets comfortable with the atmosphere, that baby gets comfortable with all the surroundings. He or she can see the lights or feel the senses. So ultimately slowly your baby is getting normalized to all the surroundings, to all the weather. So this is a very good tip, you can try it. Then next point in getting fit with your baby is you can just do it. Just hold your baby, dance with your baby, hold the hand of your partner and just enjoy the music. Because of that, a positiveness, a very happy moment is just created in your family, and ultimately that will help you to lose weight. Because by unknowingly you are doing exercise, you are not knowing that, but that really helps in reducing the weight. So this is a very good tip, you can try it on you for losing weight. Then the next important tip is massage. Yes, after post delivery, mostly in India, all the women, all the newborn mothers are preferring to massage. Massage is like a therapy, but remember that massage should be done by the trained practitioner woman. Do not appoint any woman she is not knowing the massage, because they are there are a trained professional for doing the post delivery massage. After delivery, your whole body is just want to regain its shape, just want to come back in its shape. So a trained professional is very recommended. What massage exactly does, it helps in circulating a blood properly in all over the body, and ultimately blood circulation is happens or going through your body properly, that will help in reducing your body weight. And plus on that, with the help of massage, you are having a back pain or a joint pain, because after delivery woman faces that problem, massage will reduces that pain. For duration regarding the massage, I will recommend at least for 45 to 50 days is recommended. In my case, actually I have done massage for near about 5 months, I know, but it's just give me a very good positive result. When we are talking about when can exactly we stop the massage, then in that condition, it's depending on you. After 45 days, you can stop your massage. But remember one point. Do not quit your massage all of a sudden. Because of that, your body again may have all the pains because you are having that massage, all the relaxation of your body, and all of a sudden if you are cut down your massage, then again your body will pain. So make sure by alternate day or increasing just a day gap in doing massage, you can quit your massage. Just like for alternate day, and then after 2 days, after 5 days, after 1 week, so that increase the span of doing massage, and ultimately you can quit your massage. So your body will recover easily, your body will not get ache or pains after quitting massage also. So massage is very good option for reducing the post delivery weight. Then the next important point is avoid junk food. Yes, as I mentioned that in a pregnancy phase, you have to limit down, or you have to limit your frequency or cutting down your frequency of eating the junk food. But after delivery, post delivery, you have to cut down your junk food 100%, because what you are eating, that ultimately goes to your baby via breast milk. So if you are preferring the junk food that are not having any essential vitamins, mineral, nutrients, that is not going to help your baby's healthy or proper development, so why you are eating that? That will causes the harm to your baby by one or the another way. That may causes the problem of gas, that may causes the problem of constipation. So please do not eat junk food after delivery, and ultimately plus on that, that will increases your unnecessary body weight, that will increase your body fat. So keeping junk food far away from you after delivery, that will obviously help you in reducing the body weight. Then the next important point is get some sleep. Post delivery sleep is very important, and especially if you want to reduce your weight after delivery, then sleep is actually having a very good role in that. Because after post delivery, your whole world is like upside down. You are just adjusting with your baby, you don't know how to handle that baby or what are the exactly requirements of that baby. So for your brain relaxation, your brain calming, your mind relaxation, sleep is very important. Because generally for 3 to 4 months, babies are not sleeping at the night, and because of that you have to awake a lot, you have to feed your baby frequently. So sleeping is very important. Then exactly when you can sleep, whenever your baby sleeps, just sleep with your baby at that time. If you are following that practice, then your sleep will be recovered. It happens most of the time your baby is just slept and you are not feeling sleepy. But in that case, just close your eyes and just relax your mind. That will also heal up with your positivity. Because after delivery, most of the women having a problem of post delivery depression. I am also having that problem. So sleep is very good therapy for that. And the one disadvantage of not sleeping with your baby is, as much as we awake, we know we feel hunger, and in that case we just eat some sugary or some salty food, and because of that there might be chances of gaining weight. So whenever your baby sleeps, just sleep with your baby. That ultimately give positive result on your body, on your mind. So your body will be recovered fastly, you will be get rid of that post delivery depression. So this is a very good therapy that will also help in reducing a weight. Then the next important point is eat frequently. Post delivery we feel so much of hunger because we are breastfeeding mother. So in that case, just we feel like to eat something, but make sure you are eating frequently. For once, do not eat all your food, like 4 chapatis or 5 chapatis. In my case, this is exactly what happened. After delivery, immediate delivery, I lose 6 to 7 kgs of weight, but after that I had not maintained that level and I just eat too much of food. For one time I'm remembering I ate 5 chapatis, and because of that my weight is just increased so much. That is, I was 75 to 77 kgs. So this is not a good practice. Then I consulted with my pediatrician. He said after delivery you are require 300 to 400 calories, that is sufficient, but just यू आर ईटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ फूड दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू हेल्प यू बिकॉज अननेसेसरी दैट जस्ट अक्यूमुलेट फैट्स इन योर बॉडी दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू फॉर्म ब्रेस्ट मिल्क. सो 300 to 400 कैलरीज सफिशियंट. ईट फ्रिक्वेंटली मीन्स यू हैव टू डिवाइड यूअर फूड इन एवरी 2 to 3 आवर्स. लाइक इन ब्रेकफास्ट यू हैव टू ईट समथिंग, लाइक इन लंच इफ ऑन रेगुलर बेसिस यू आर ईटिंग 3 to 4 चपातीज, देन यू हैव टू ईट 1 to 2 चपाती. आफ्टर 2 hours इफ यू फील हंग्री देन यू कैन ईट 1 to 2 चपाती. सो इन दिस वे यू कैन डिवाइड यूअर मील. एंड इफ यू आर प्रिफरिंग फ्रूट्स देन दैट विल ऑल्सो वेरी गुड ऑप्शन फॉर वेट लॉस. सो ईट फ्रिक्वेंटली, डिवाइड यूअर होल मील इन एटलीस्ट 6 to 7 मील्स, स्मॉल मील्स दैट विल ऑब्वियसली हेल्प यू इन रिड्यूसिंग द वेट आफ्टर डिलीवरी. देन नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज ईट अर्ली. येस, इट्स एक्चुअली अ वेरी स्टेटेड थंब रूल काइंड ऑफ थिंग. वेन यू हैव टू लूज यूअर वेट देन यू हैव टू ईट अर्ली बिफोर एटलीस्ट 2 to 3 आवर्स of your sleep. That will give a proper digestion of that food and the food is properly digested, then automatically your stomach will be smooth and that help in reducing the weight. Do not eat food before your just sleep time. Like if you are sleeping at 10 o'clock and if you are eating at 9:30 or 9:45, that is not going to help you in reducing the weight. So try to eat early. That will obviously help in reducing the weight. Then the next important point is stay active. As I mentioned, for at least 45 days, this is your recovery phase. You are not able to do anything heavy exercise or anything heavy work which is available at your home. So please engage yourself in doing light activities by just doing cleaning your room or by just folding your baby's clothes or by just playing with your baby. If you are engaging yourself in active mode, then for a long term that will obviously or ultimately keep you away from your all laziness, and ultimately that is a parallel equation. As much as active you are, that will as much as you are losing your weight. So keeping yourself active is a very good option for losing weight. Then the next important point is don't drink caffeine or don't drink soda. Yes, as I mentioned earlier, now you are a breastfeeding mother. If you are drinking that soda or you are drinking that all carbon dioxide containing liquid, that is not good for your health, and especially that is not good for your baby's health because you are a breastfeed mother. What you are eating, what you are drinking, that goes to your baby via breast milk. So just avoid the soda or the caffeine too much. In a day, at least 1 to 2 cup of coffee is okay. That is not going to harm you or your baby. But you have to cut down your soda level, or you are drinking any kind of that soft drink or carbon dioxide containing drink that is having so much sugar in that, and ultimately that is not healthy for you, that is not healthy for your baby. So extra sugar, extra soda, extra carbon dioxide containing drinks, extra soft drinks, that is not actually healthy for you. And for reducing the weight, that all be cut down after delivery while in pregnancy phase, that actually should not be included in your diet. Then the next important point is do not drink alcohol. Actually, alcohol is cut down totally when you are pregnant. In pregnancy phase, alcohol is not allowed, and after delivery, alcohol is also not allowed because you are a breastfeed mother. You just have to focus on your baby. You have to think that before taking anything or before drinking anything that is going to your baby. So your baby is priority now. Do not drink alcohol, or if you are a habit of smoking, just quit all that. As soon as you came to know that you are pregnant, then all the drinking habits, then all the smoking habit, you have to just quit it off for your baby's healthy development, for your baby's growth. And ultimately, if you are away from the alcohol or smoking, that will ultimately helps in reducing your post-delivery weight. Then the next important point is do exercise. When I am saying do exercise, we are going to divide this terminology because in delivery or after delivery there are different phases. So the initial phase is up to 40 days. In that condition, you are not allowed to do any exercise because it's your recovery phase, it's your baby's recovery phase. In that case, as I mentioned earlier, you can keep yourself active by doing your household activities, light activities, just by cleaning your room or just by cleaning your baby's clothes or just by folding your baby's clothes or just by cleaning your baby's utensils. So this is kind of exercise, a very light exercise that really helps you in keeping active. That is important up to 40 days. After 40 days, up to 6 months, yes. Till the 6 months, you are not allowed to do any heavy exercise. You are not allowed to go to gym or to do any heavy yoga. Because in cesarean section, there are stitches from the outer side, from the inner side. Outer stitches, a doctor can see and he said when it is exactly recovered. But we are talking about the stitches from the inner side. We don't know what exactly time required for its healing. So you are not having any permission by your gynecologist to do any heavy exercise till the 6 months. So for what we can do up to 6 months, you can do walk. It's totally depend on you. You can do 30 minutes, 45 or even 60 minutes walk in a day up to 6 months. After 6 months, you are allowed to do a little bit of exercise, but only by the guidance of your gynecologist. So after 6 months, you may be allowed to go to gym, you may be allowed to go to yoga, or you may be allowed to pull up the heavy weights, but it's totally depend on your condition, on your health. If your gynecologist permits you, then you can start this. And the main important point is, up to 6 months, you are not allowed to lose any post-delivery weight, because your baby is purely 100% dependent on you. Your baby is breastfed, so your gynecologist will not give you any permission to lose weight for at least 6 months. After 6 months, you can do exercise, and if you are doing exercise, then ultimately that will help in reducing your weight. But if you are following that thing which I mentioned earlier, that is after immediate delivery, your 6 to 7 kgs of weight is already loose. And if you are still on that weight, then what I mentioned earlier, if you are following all that points, then ultimately the remaining weight will be lost. So 7 kgs at the time or immediately after the time of delivery, and the remaining weight after delivery by following all the points which I mentioned. So ultimately your weight loss journey will be very successful. You are get to your original shape. But make sure up to 6 months, please do not do any diet, because your baby is purely depending on you. You do not drink or do not eat any unhealthy, any fast food, any junk food. If you are following all the tips, if you are just focusing on what I said for losing weight, if you just follow that, then ultimately within a 1 year, you are becoming to your original shape. Because this practice actually I had tried and followed by me, and you don't trust, I loses my 20 kgs of weight, because after delivery I am about 75 kgs, and before 1 year I was on the original, that is 54 to 55. In Raghav's birthday I was in my original shape. I just followed all the tips which I mentioned you. This is all my experience. If you are following that, then ultimately that will help you in losing weight, your post delivery weight. Then the last point is actually I just want to mention is, be realistic. Yes, when we talk about the weight loss, this is not going to happen all of a sudden. While doing weight loss journey, you just have to positiveness inside you. You just have to patience inside you. What happens, we think that in 1 month we are going to lose our 5 kgs or 10 kgs, and if that is not happening, then we demoralize ourselves and we just quit the all weight loss journey. So keep in mind, weight loss is a long term journey, and if you are losing slowly, then ultimately that is very good for your health, for your long term journey. Do not expect that you are losing so much of weight as soon as you started your weight loss journey. This is not going to happen. Keep patience, be positive. Weight loss is a long term. You will definitely reach this journey. For that, just focus on your weight loss. Just focus on what you are eating. That must be healthy, that must be correct. So ultimately you will reach out your goal. This is all about today's video, that is the post delivery weight loss. I hope you like today's video. From my side, I actually tried to cover it in thorough, because it's a weight loss journey is mine. What I explained in today's video, this is all which is I followed in my journey. It gives me a very positive result. So I hope that will also give a very positive result to you also. If you really like the video, please hit the like button for me. Please subscribe Mom on Board, be a member of Mom on Board, comment, press the bell icon. If you are having anything extra or anything else which is actually going to help me or other people, then please share that information with us by commenting. And please share this video more and more. Very soon we will meet in my next video. Till then, please take care of good health of yourself and please be on board and be in touch.